Hello everyone, welcome back to my weekend updates. This last week, I decided on and began development for what I plan on being a month-long endeavor, Tree Month. This so-called Tree Month is going to consist of two main arboreal topics, the plant's procedural generation, and the use of an octree data structure to compress the size of the world. I've already begun working on both these topics, however, the plant generation is considerably more visual, so let's take a look at that. I'm using a signed distance field to define how these trees should generate, and I've got to say, it's so much fun. I first learned of this concept years ago from the video How to Make 3D Fractals by CodeParade. Check it out in the link below, it's awesome. He talks about ray marching, which is a graphics concept somewhat similar to how I'm rendering the voxels in my own project. So how do I even go about creating a function that gives the distance away from a seemingly complicated shape like a spruce tree? Well, it's actually pretty simple, though I don't think I'm the best to explain it. Who is, however, is a man named Inigo Quilez, who may be better known as IQ on Shadertoy. I only recently came across his YouTube channel, but it's amazing. He used to work making computer graphics at Pixar, I believe, and goes into great detail about making some beautiful art with math. On his Shadertoy page, he has a few projects that contain the functions to retrieve the distance for many various 3D and 2D shapes. So I went ahead and ported some of those functions over to work inside my projects, as you can see here. And I combined them to create what I wanted. This spruce tree, for example, is made up of just a few simple shapes. I first use an elongated sphere, or capsule. Then a few cylinders, technically I'm using a truncated cone with no slope because at one point I had a slope, a cone at the top, and a torus around this lower cylinder that technically breaks the SDF at non-zero distances because I randomized the minor radius based on a number calculated per block. It looks silly at this scale, but since it's just a function of the position at each tile, we can scale it right down very easily. And that results in a nicer looking shape. You might have noticed that I've shown some of the code, when it may have seemed as though I was going to keep this project closed source. While that's partially true, I love the open source community and want to contribute as well. I greatly value people who provide things allowing me to learn for free, so I thought I would let you all know that all the code up to this point is currently publicly available on GitHub in this repository. It's a Vulkan abstraction library created by a good friend of mine, Patrick. It allows me to rapidly iterate on this project with ease, and he also helps me with suggestions on how to optimize my code. You can check it out now, though there are a couple branches where I've been experimenting with different things. I'm currently adjusting the build system in the packaged branch to allow me to consume the library from an external project, which I intend to keep private for the time being. I will soon make a video demonstrating how anyone can use our library through CMake and VC package to very simply create Vulkan applications. The API of this library, however, will be drastically changing as Patrick updates it, but I'll do my best to keep the VC package port up to date so that it's working as intended.